Hi, I'm Stephen Feuerstein, and I write practically perfect PLSQL. So, let's take a look at one of the most frustrating errors that PLSQL developers encounter on compile time, and that's PLS-306, wrong number or types of arguments in the call to a certain subprogram. So as the Oracle error messages document says, this error occurs when the name subprogram call cannot be matched to any declaration for that subprogram name. So the subprogram name might be misspelled, the parameter might have the wrong data type, there might be the wrong number. It's pretty much what it says in the error message. So you might say, well, what's the big deal? Well, the big deal is that unfortunately, Oracle doesn't tell us which argument name might be wrong or which one is missing or there are too many, there are too few. So you often have to do a little detective work to sort out what the problem can be. For simple programs, it can be simple. For more complicated programs, a bit more complicated. Let's take a look at some examples. So let's start with a package called sales package. It has three different subprograms, all called calc total, so it's overloaded. One of them has a parameter called zone in, type string. The second procedure has a parameter called region in, also a string. And the third subprogram is a function that has the same parameter zone in, single string, returning a number. The implementation is rather silly. It just displays a message or returns zero. So the zone version displays zone, region version displays region. And these packages, as you can see here, both compiled without any error whatsoever. Oracle said they're fine. Let's try using them. I wrote a program. Sure would be nice to use it. So as you can see in my call to the sales package calc total program, I'm passing it a value of true. Let's see what happens when I run this code. And the answer is compilation error, there it is, 306, wrong number or types of arguments in call to calc total. Why did that happen? Well, let's go back to the definition of the package. I have two different procedure overloadings and I called a procedure. So first of all, Oracle says, well, I need to look at the two procedure definitions, not the function. And it says I've got a string for zone in, and I've got a string for region in. And the question is this a string? No, it's not a string, it's a Boolean value. Can it be converted to a string? No, you can't convert Booleans to strings. So Oracle says that's the wrong type for this argument. Now, if I put in 123, let's try that, right? Passing 123, that's a string, so that should work, right? Run my code again. Now, in this case, I've got a slightly different error, which I'll explore in detail in a separate episode, which is 307. Too many declarations of calc total match this call. So the problem wasn't that with my data type or the number of arguments I'm passing. I've only got one I can pass in for any of these, and they're strings. The problem is Oracle couldn't figure out which one. Like I say, we'll come back to that. But definitely passing true didn't work. And if I pass more than one parameter, so pass two dates. Run my code. Wrong number or types of arguments in call to calc total. So as I mentioned before, for simple occurrences, what's the big deal? I look at my code, it says wrong number or types. I've got 1, 2. Go back to my original version of my code, the definition, and I look and I see 1, no 2. I can't have two arguments, so I'm going to go back and say it shouldn't be two, it should just be one. Run my code, and now you might be saying, but it doesn't accept a date, it accepts a string, Stephen. You're getting an error. Ah, well, in this case, still too many declarations, but let's fix that for a moment. Just to show you that, in fact, I can call this program with a date. No problem, because, of course, a date can be converted to a string. So while we might look at this and say, that looks like the wrong type, for Oracle, it's not the wrong type because Oracle makes such an effort to help us get our job done, including implicit conversions of data types, even if it's not always such a great idea to rely on Oracle to do that for us. Okay. Now, another problem you might run into relates to name notation. So what I wrote right here, and I kind of skipped over the explanation of it, is I explicitly associated this parameter, zone in, with this argument value sysdate. So the equal greater than symbol is the association symbol, and it's called name notation. I'm naming which parameter goes with which argument value, and that worked. Here's another version that doesn't work so well. So pass an ABC and associate it with the zone, because, you know, at a glance, I've got zone, string, good to go. Run my code. Oh no, PLS-306, wrong number of types or arguments. So what's going on? Well, again, because it's a simple program, it's pretty easy to see that my parameter name is not correct. It needs to be zone in. Then when I run it, no problem. Now, when you have a parameter list of 15 or 20 parameters, it's often hard to see what the problem might be. For example, what I often run into is because my standard approach, my naming convention for parameters is underscore in or underscore out and so on. Sometimes in a long list of parameters, I'll leave off the underscore in on just one of them and not realize it. Of course, Oracle says that's fine. You don't have to have that suffix on your parameter name. So it compiles right. But then when I try to use it and I use my convention, it says, sorry, that doesn't work. And it takes me a while to realize, to actually question the assumption, did I define my procedure correctly? So sometimes it can be very frustrating to track down the cause of the 306. Probably the most important thing is to not assume anything. Take a step back and ask, did I define the parameter list as I'm using it here? Are these values compatible with the data types of the parameters themselves? And this is an interesting example too. Let's suppose I've got a cursor for loop. So for every employee in the select from the employees table, I'm going to display the employee last name. Oops. So that, let's see if that works. Run my code. Anonymous block completed. If we look at the output, and I turned it on, we see the code. There are all my employees. But what sometimes happens is something more like this. Display my employee. For each employee, just display it. It seems so reasonable. Run my code. Wrong number or types of arguments and call it a putline. Well, putline only accepts strings or anything that can be implicitly converted to a string. And there's no way Oracle can convert a record to a string. So again, in simple code, it should stand out pretty clearly that you missed something here. But in more complicated code, especially depending on the way you name things, it can be hard to get focused on what could be causing that problem. And finally, just to give you an interesting glimpse at how the compiler works, I'm going to do roughly the same code, but now I'm going to say name equals and concatenate it to employee. I run my code. And now I get an interesting message. Wrong number or types of arguments in call to the concatenation operator. That's kind of strange looking, isn't it? We think about the concatenation operators being a built-in part of the language. It's not a function that you're passing parameters to, but in fact, it does function, work in the same way. So what's happening now is that Oracle is complaining about the fact that I'm trying to concatenate a record to a string. It just doesn't make any sense. But at first glance, when we wrote it, it seemed okay. And the fix is, of course, to specify the individual field that will give you the data you want. And then it will show you what you want. And there are the other names somewhere down here. Way down there. All the new names. So probably the most important message about the 306 error is to really believe it. Wrong number or types of arguments in the call to that program. So the first thing you do is check the number. Do I have the correct number of parameter values that I'm passing through? If I have too many, that's usually pretty clear. I've got four parameters, I've got five values. Doesn't work. The trickier part is when you've got a smaller number of parameters that are being passed into the procedure than the full list because you have default values and you want to use the defaults, and then you might be using name notation. Then it can get kind of tricky to figure out what's missing, where where things aren't correlating properly. In terms of wrong types, that can get tricky because of implicit conversions. But if you take Oracle at its word that you're looking at a problem with the number or the data type, even for longer complex lists, as long as you focus on the actual text that's there, don't make assumptions. Don't say, I know how I name things. Actually look at what you wrote. You can usually sort out the problem in relatively short order. So hopefully these tips will help you with your PLS 306, and happy PLSQL coding.